The best way to move a chart is slide over mouse, grab inside of chart area, then click and drag. We see that chart is moving in any direction we want. If we want to resize it, we point to one of the four corners handles. A diagonal arrow appears. We click and resize it narrower or wider. Another way to resize is by holding down Alt key. But there is a difference now. When we drag it, the edges align exactly with the cell boundaries in the background. We leave first the mouse and then Alt key. Our chart is perfectly aligned with the cell corner. A nice trick. Sometimes we need to keep the same ratio of width to height. To keep aspect ratio same, we click on the lower right corner of the chart and before dragging it, we press Shift key. We have made to keep same ratio without change, only height or only width. Now let's try something different. Let's click and drag on an edge and simultaneously press Ctrl key. We can see that we keep the same center of the chart. A nice feature of Excel is chart templates. If we have our favorite charts with specific colors, etc., we can save them as template. How we do that? Simply right-click on that specific chart and press Save as template. Give it a file name, for example my favorite, and don't change the folder. Now click Save. Okay, where are our template charts and how can we show them up? Click on Pie Chart Worksheet and then click on Chart. Go to Design tab and press Change Chart Type. Then choose Templates. As we can see, our favorite chart appears. Click on it and we are ready. We can have as many templates as we want and we can easily delete them. For example, go again to Templates folder. Click on Manage Templates button. Find the chart, right click and delete. If we click on a chart, we will see the cells being represented in the chart with three different colors. Red for the programs, purple for the years and finally blue for values. If we don't want to show year 2014, simply click on lower right corner, drag to the left and release our mouse. Our chart now shows only the first 4 years. An easier way to do the same thing is simply click on the Outlook line. It is the yellow line. See the highlighted cells that corresponding with that line. Also, we can see in formula bar some addressing. It shows exactly the highlighted cells, but it is far more complex. Press delete and the specific line disappears. Let's press undo again. By changing the color of our chart is one of the most useful and pleasant settings. How do we do that? Click on the chart. Go to the Design tab. On our left we see Change Color Settings. We have two categories of colors. The colorful, which is a group of colors, and monochromatic, because of the same color theme. We can live preview before we click on it. Thanks for watching.